The administration has held a supermajority in the House since Duterte took power. However, it hasn't been exactly smooth sailing over the past 5 years, with a power play leading to the ouster of Pantaleon Alvarez as Speaker during Duterte's third SONA, and a leadership standoff a year later, almost derailing a term-sharing deal brokered by the president himself. Now, witness to all of these is our House correspondent, RG Cruz. Hi, RG. Welcome to the program.
Good morning. Good morning to all of our viewers.
All right. You've covered the House of Representatives extensively all through 5 years of this administration. How was the president's performance in terms of pushing for his legislative agenda? I would assume it would have been smooth sailing since it was a productive 5 years, considering he has enjoyed the support of many lawmakers. And up until this day, there is no indication he has become a lame duck president.
Well, Stanley, as I said in my report earlier, he managed to get 15 out of 47 priorities become law. So that's just a third. So to some observers, particularly to Dr. Francisco Magno, who we spoke to in our report, that's not really much to show about or to show for. And if you ask me, it's really because they were bogged down by politics, and they also wasted time. Well, I wouldn't call it waste, but they spent a lot of time on issues that really would have a hard time getting a consensus in the other chambers. So we're talking about the House of Representatives here. So first, let's go through that very briefly. They spent time on charter change. They spent time on death penalty. They spent time on lowering the age of criminal responsibility. During the speakership of Pantaleon Alvarez, they even spent time on divorce. So these are measures that, while it may be popular or while it gained the votes to pass the House, it did not get the support that it needed to get through the Senate. So that's why that's one factor. And then, of course, as you also mentioned, there has been a lot of politics and power play in the chamber, in the House of Representatives. While that did not necessarily lead to the bogging down of the legislative mill as much as the failure to forge a consensus on the other legislative priority measures, that still took time of the House. And we must remember that President Duterte, at least in terms of the four, in terms of the post 1986 president, has had the most number of speakers of the House. So he's had four.
Yeah.
So that's Pantaleon Alvarez, that's Gloria Macapagal-Arroyo, that's Alan Peter Cayetano, and of course now the incumbent Speaker Lord Alan Velasco. In the case of the 17th Congress, he had two speakers there because there was a leadership change in 2018. We all remember that. We all remember the images vividly from that day.
Yeah.
In terms of the 18th Congress, we all know that there was an attempt to make sure that there is no more conflict by forging a term sharing agreement between two congressmen, Speaker Velasco and Speaker Cayetano. But of course, we all know how that ended too. It did not achieve the stability that they hoped it would achieve, because ever since that term sharing agreement was forged, there has been persistent rumors of coup. Now, let's just put it in the proper context. Every time there's a SONA, every time there's a break in Congress, and I've been covering the House for about 15, 16 years already, it's par for the course for there to be rumors of a coup. But that has never happened, except in the case of 2018 and in 2008, of course, during the speakership of Joe DeVenecia and his replacement by the late Prospero Nogales. So, yung chismis hindi mawawala yan. Pero yung the fact that it actually happened at least twice, the case of Speaker Arroyo and Speaker Velasco, that says something about the kind of relationship that the president has with his allies.
Yeah, RG, a year left before the president's term ends, and he still enjoys that support from, well, a majority at least. What priority legislation do you think will be pushed in his remaining months, aside from those probably related to the pandemic?
Okay, Stanley, earlier during his opening speech to the opening session, Speaker Velasco already enumerated which measures these are. That's, of course, there's the 2022 national budget, which is the final budget of the administration. Then there's also the bills on the Filipino or the Virology Institute of the Philippines, the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, the Retail Trade Liberalization Act, the Foreign Investments Act, and the Public Service Act. They're also hoping to work on the Ease of Paying Taxes Bill and the reform on the pension of military and uniform personnel. They're also looking at more reforms in the National Internal Revenue Code, among other bills that they hope to be able to achieve. But, you know, remember, Stanley, that this is not, they don't really have a full year for this final session because that 2022 elections is at hand. So in reality, they actually only have until October this year. Although, you know, of course, the legislative calendar says it's until next year. In reality, by October of 2021, Congress will be going on a short break to file their certificates of candidacy. And from then onwards, you will see more congressmen be busy with their own election campaigns, whether for re-election or for another position. But it remains to be seen, though, if they can actually still perform their tasks. In pre-pandemic times, after the filing of candidacies, it's already hard to achieve a quorum. But now, since you have a pandemic which allows them to work from home and work from everywhere,
and prohibits them from campaigning face-to-face.
There's that too. So there might be a chance that they can multitask. And we've seen that happen in the past. I've seen that in committee hearings and in sessions where, ever since the pandemic began, where the lawmakers would not necessarily be in their homes or in their private offices, but they'd be on the road, they'd be in their car. So you see that there's this effort to multitask. So who knows, maybe they'll be able to pull it off.
Yeah, we'll try to see how that pans out. RG Groos, thanks a lot.